Good morning. I'm going to present our work on DMSO clusters. We have investigated the non-covalent interaction and the DFT benchmarking of DMSO clusters. The work is going to be presented by me. I'm Alhaj Maloum from the University of the Free State. I am doing postdoc in the University of the Free State, and I am also a lecturer at the University of Marwa from Cameroon. My work is conducted in collaboration with Professor Conradi Janet from the University of the Free State. The motivation behind the work we have conducted here is that we want to understand the property of liquid DMSO at molecular level. Actually, there is no study that is providing the molecular level understanding of liquid properties. There is this theory that has been proposed recently, that is the quantum cluster equilibrium theory, that use clusters of molecule to determine the some properties of liquid. The quantum cluster equilibrium theory is based on quantum statistical thermodynamic computing using canonical ensemble. This QCE theory used the knowledge of the structure of the clusters, their relative energies, as well as their vibrational frequencies. So when someone can determine accurately different structures of a given molecule or a given liquid, for example, for this case we are talking about DMSO, when someone is able to determine all the clusters of DMSO from small size, that is n equal to 2, to large size, as large as possible, one can use these structures as well as their relative energy in the cluster quantum cluster equilibrium theory to determine some properties of liquids. So that is the main guidance or our main motivation in this work. So we started at the basic level, that is determining all the possible structures there and then calculate their relative energies and their vibrational frequencies, then later on use it in the quantum cluster equilibrium theory. So in this work we are going to determine all the possible structures from dimer to tetramer. So we limited our studies at only n equal to 4 solvent molecules. Actually, it will be very expensive to go beyond this number of clusters. So the main objective of this work is to determine these possible structures for each cluster size, then study their non-covalent interactions, and after studying their non-covalent interaction, we will use benchmarking of DFT to determine the most suitable DFT functional that can be used for large size clusters. So after thorough exploration of the potential energy surface of these clusters, we are presenting on this slide only the possible structures that have been located for n equal to 3. The other clusters are not presented here, just to avoid some cumbersome. So the location of this structure shows that the structures have no definite symmetry, most of them, only this structure, the second most stable structure that has some given symmetry. Also, we have use the IEM all program to determine the non-covalent interactions in these clusters. So we can see here the critical points that are presented, and we can also see the non-covalent interaction that are presented in dashed lines. From these investigations, it comes out that in DMSO clusters, we have about 8 different non-covalent interactions. From these non-covalent interactions, our investigation have shown that the hydrogen bonds are the strongest non-covalent interactions, while the hydrogen-hydrogen bonding are found to be the weakest non-covalent interaction. This result is based on the value of the density at the critical points that can be seen in this table. So in addition to non-covalent interaction, we have also tried to understand the stability of these clusters when the temperature is increased. So it we have presented here the case of the trimer and the case of the third trimer. So it comes out that when the temperature is increased, actually only 2 of these structures are really meaningful, are contributing to the population of the clusters. The other 2 are really negligible. So their contribution will be negligible to the whole property of the system. For the case of the tetramer, we have also seen that among all the located isomers, only 4 of them are contributing to the population of the clusters, while the remaining are also negligible. After examining the temperature effect, we have now calculated the binding energies. For the binding energies, we used 10 DFT functionals. For each DFT functional, we used the AVTZ, the triple Zeta basis set, and we used the DLPNO-CCSDT-CBS as a benchmark for these DFT functionals. After calculating these bending energies, we have calculated the mean absolute deviation as compared to this to our benchmark, and also we have calculated the root mean square error and the maximum deviation from the benchmark values. And it comes out from that study that this functional, which is WB97XD, is the best functional to study the DMSO clusters, because the binding energies are found to be closer to the benchmark values. So the second most established structure is this PW6B95D3. So among all the assessed functionals, we recommended these 2 functionals to be used for the investigation of large size DMSO clusters. So in this work, we have investigated the structures and the non-covalent interaction of DMSO clusters at the MP2 level of theory. This investigation is quite expensive and cannot be done for large size clusters. For that, we have performed a benchmarking study so that we can find a most suitable DFT functional which is less expensive that can be used for large size clusters. And our study revealed that these 2 functional, WB97XD and PW6B95D3, are the most suitable functional for the study of DMSO clusters. The result of this work will be now used to understand and to determine the properties of liquid DMSO. This work has been done only by the contribution of CHPC. Without this contribution, the resources from CHPC, we cannot perform this work, especially the calculation at the DLP NO CCSDT, and also the optimization of the frequency calculation at the MP2 are very time consuming. That will not be able without the contribution of CHPC. For further discussion, you can email me at this email. Thank you for following the presentation. Bye.